Today I am going to deliver a lecture, linear algebra lecture 1 on vector space by Dr. P. Ramlu, head department of mathematics, MVS Government Arts and Science College, Mahabubnagar, right? So today only I want to discuss vector space. So for discussing vector space I need some sets, okay? So what is vector space, right? So before going to give lecture on vector space, now I want to define set. Already we know that, already explained in third semester and fourth semester about set. I can recall it. So still I want to write written. So the collection of well-defined distinct object is called a set. Collection of well-defined distinct object is called a set. For example, students in the class. I'm taking that students in the class is the example, right? Simple example. I'm taking other example. S is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. S is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this is other example, one example. S is equal to singleton 0. This is also one set. N equal to 1, 2, 3, up to so on, so on. Natural numbers. Whole numbers. Integers, rational numbers, IR. So you can that irrational number. I'm not doing here irrational numbers, real numbers. Real nothing but Q union R minus Q. Integers. Okay. Real numbers are but rational and irrational number. These are irrational number. These are rational. Rational number. R minus Q written as IR also. Complex number. C. C is equal to a plus ib such that a comma b belongs to R, where I not I equal to root square root of minus 1. This is a complex number set. Okay, mn cross n over f. I'm denoting this set is a set of all n by n cross matrix over the set I'm denoting over the set f. Where each aij belonging to this f. Yeah, let a equal to aij n cross n. Here, this is my aijs are a11, a12, a11. So, up to n cross n. This is n cross n matrix. I am taking a. M n cross m over f. So, this is n by order, m order matrix. A equal to aij m cross m, so is equal to a11, a12, a1m, a21, a22, divided as a2m. So this is n by m order matrix. You can take that z of I goes in integer. So a plus ib says that a comma b plus t. So it looks like complex number, but there are real numbers. So I am taking a Gaussian integer. Therefore, z of I equal to a plus ib says that a comma b belonging to z. So S is equal to, I am taking AI plus BJ plus CK such that A comma B comma C comma. So vector forms belonging to R. So these are the examples of set which I want to use in my real analysis, sorry, vector space. So in linear algebra, right? P of X. I am doing the P of X. So A naught A1X plus A1X divided by where each AI is belonging to real numbers. So you can take that not on real number, you can F, it may be some Q, it may be Z, anything. If AI is belonging to, you may take that anything. Pn of X. Here Pn of X, here I am taking the infinite polynomial. So that is a double polynomial. Here I am taking the polynomial of degree n. So the full polynomial of degree a naught plus a1x plus z as anx power n such that a is belonging to R. This is Pn of X. So I am doing R2. R2 nothing but R cross R. R2 nothing but R cross R. R cross R equal to what? How to define here? A, B such that A comma R. It is look like Cartesian of two sets. Cartesian of two real numbers. A comma says that A comma belongs to R. So Yeah, in my vector space, this may be written as in the form of, I feel that this is row matrix, it is a column matrix. We may define that R2 equal to AB such that A comma belongs to R also. Similarly, R3, R cross R, that equal to ABC such that ABC belongs to R. So you may write this in the column vectors. Okay. This A comma B belongs to R, C comma belongs to R here. Yeah. If I take n cross n, AB belonging to n. If I take z square, so z to 2, we can write here, a z comma z also belonging to, sorry, this a comma belongs to z. If I take r4n equal to r cross r, that means this quadrant product of n overs are there. Here I am writing here a1, a2, data as an, such that each a is belonging to R. So this is in the form of row. This may be written as in the form of column. Okay, each A is belonging to R. You may write similar C2, C cross C, that equal to here. Just previously, I am taking here R cross R. A comma belongs to A comma B such that A comma B belongs to. Here I am C cross C, that's why I am writing A comma B such that A comma B belongs to R. C. That equal to AB such that A comma B belongs to C. You here you can take the CN, C cross C such that you can take that CA1, A2, data as AN, each A is belonging to C. That equal to A1, A2, data as AN such that A is belonging to C. You can take that. So quaternions, you can take that a naught a1i plus a2j plus a3k, so is that each a0 a1 a2 all belongs to z. I square j square k square ij k equal to minus 1 and I cross j equal to k, j cross k equal to I, k cross I equal to j. So these sets I'm going to use in my linear algebra topic and to define vector spaces, right? So we may use some other also. This set I'm going to explain now only. You may use some other set also. If it is forget, I will explain later. Okay, which set I forget, right? So when I going to define vector space, I required some small definitions. For that reason, I'm here explaining binary operation. Okay, what is binary operation? Let S be a non-empty set and star be any operation. If A comma B belongs to S, which implies A star B belongs to S, then star is said to be binary operation on S. Let S be a non-empty set and star be any operation. If A comma B belongs to S, which implies A star B belongs to S, then star is said to be binary operation on S. You may take that operation or in place of star, you may take that plus, minus, dot, divide. Okay. S nothing but we may take anything. So simply I'm sitting on writing one, n natural number set 1 into 3, 4. If I take 1 comma 2 belongs to n, which implies 1 plus 2 equal to 3, that also belongs to n. So this is binary operation. In place of S, you can take anything. All sets already I explained in last class. I am realizing, so you may use that, right? Closure property. Let us be a non-empty set and star be any binary operation on S. If A comma B belongs to S, which implies A star B belongs to S, then S satisfies closure property with respect to star. Example, N W Z Q or satisfies closure property with respect to addition. I explained that you can take any two elements. So A star comma B comma belongs to S. Then if I apply with respect to plus operation, the result will be also in this set. That's why it satisfies closure property with respect to addition. Associative property. Let S be a non-empty subset and star be any operation, binary operation on S. So star be any binary operation on S. if a star b star c is equal to a star b star c for all a comma b belongs to S, then S satisfies associative property with respect to star. Example, you can work that NWZQR satisfies associative property with respect to addition. Identity property. Let S be a non-empty set and star be any operation on S. If for all A belongs to S, there exists E belongs to S such that A star E is equal to E star A equal to A, then S satisfies identity property with respect to star and E is an identity element in S. You can easily remember that let S be a non-empty set and star be any operation on S. You can boost up. If for all A belongs to S, there exists an element E belongs to S such that A star is equal to E, E star is equal to A, that equal to A, then we say that S satisfies identity property with respect to star and this element is called an identity element in S. So NWZQR has identity element with respect to dot and identity element is 1. With respect to here, you can take that 1 dot x is equal to x dot 1 equal to 1 for all x belongs to these sets. Simply can observe that here a dot 1, e dot 1 that equal to a for all a belonging to this set. Take any number. If I multiply any number, we will get this only. With respect to 0 also, you can take that a plus 0 is equal to 0 plus a equal to a for all a equal to in this set. You can take that for all a belongs to w, j, d, q. 0 does not belong to n, that's why I am not writing mentioned here, right? So this is by identity property condition, right? Inverse property. Let S be a non-empty set and star be any operation on S. So if for all A belongs to S, there exists B belongs to S such that A star B is equal to B star E is equal to E, then S satisfies inverse property with respect to star and B is an inverse element of A and E is an identity element here. I am taking that S be a non-empty set and star be any operation on S. So I am taking that E is an element. Okay, E is an element element too. If for all A belongs to there exists B belongs to such that A star B is equal to B star equal to E, then S satisfies inverse property with respect to star and B is called an inverse element of A. Here ZQR has inverse element with respect to addition. So you can observe here with respect to addition, Z, if I, what is the identity element or sorry, inverse element of A here, you can take that A, what is the identity element with respect to 0, sorry, with respect to addition, 0, A plus B is equal to B plus A is equal to E, B plus A equal to 0. What can I substitute in place of B, that equal to minus A? So negative numbers belonging to this set, so that's why I'm writing A minus A is equal to minus A plus A, that equal to 0. Therefore, minus A is an inverse of A with respect to addition. You can easily say that minus A is an inverse element of A with respect to addition in this sets. So that's why inverse of, right? Group. Let S be a non-empty set and star be any operation, binary operation on S. So if S satisfies closer associative identity inverse property with respect to star, then S comma star is a group. Let S be a non-empty set and star be any operation on S. So if S satisfies closer associative identity inverse property with respect to SR, then S comma star is a group. Example, Z complex and Q complex, R complex, Q star comma dot, R star comma dot, singleton, zero complex dot, right? So these are the groups, okay? In second year, I already explained in details, okay? You may observe of my lectures in real analysis, so you find detailed report, right? So in this topic, I want to define vector space. In there, I will explain detail. So, but for this case, you can learn from observing videos in in real analysis videos. Okay. Abelian property. Let S be a non-empty set and star be any binary operation on S. So if A star B is equal to B star A for all A comma belongs to S, then S satisfies abelian property with respect to star. So example n w z q or c satisfies abelian property with respect to plus comma dot. You can write that a dot b b dot a. Simply can write a dot b equal to b dot a. Simply that a plus b is equal to b plus a. Which set not satisfied with respect to any other proper any other operation. If you take minus, then what happen? A minus. So suppose if I take n a minus 1 minus 1 1 minus 2 is equal to not equal to 2 minus 1. 1 minus 2 is equal to minus 1. 2 minus 1 equal to 1. So therefore, if I take my operation minus, that does not satisfy the abelian property with respect to these sets. You can take that. This set does not satisfy the abelian property with respect to minus. Also divide. Okay, observe here. My set does not satisfy, so abelian property with respect to divide also. Yeah, abelian group. Let S be an unordered set and star be any binary operation on S. So if S satisfies closure, associative, identity, inverse and abelian properties with respect to star, then S comma star is called an abelian group. Okay, so Z comma plus comma, Q comma plus comma dot, R comma plus, right? These are the abelian property. So before going to discuss abelian property, you may define other way, right? So abelian property already discussed. What can I do now? Yeah, we can define other way also. A group G comma plus G comma star is said to be abelian group if it satisfies abelian property. Simply, instead of five properties, you can write only one direct, right? A group G comma star is said to be abelian group if it satisfies abelian property. So this can also explain, right? You can simply observe that Z complex, Q complex, R complex or satisfies abelian group properties. That's why these are the abelian group, right? So before going to discuss that, I required another definition, field. Okay, what is field? Let F be a non-empty set and comma F comma plus comma dot is said to be field if F comma plus is an abelian group and F minus singleton 0 comma dot is an abelian group. So both are abelian groups. F comma plus and F star, you can write F minus singleton, you can write F star comma dot is an abelian group. Or a commutative division ring is called field. Simply, a commutative division ring is called field. Other way also, a commutative division ring with unity is said to be field if every non-zero element has inverse. Every non-zero element has inverse. A commutative ring with unity is said to be field if every non-zero element has inverse. So these are the examples of field. Q comma plus comma dot, R comma plus comma dot, C comma plus comma dot or field. Why? Because so these fields, so in fourth semester we are learning about this. So how it is filled? Why? Because Q complex is an abelian group and Q comma dot, Q star comma dot is abelian group. That's why. So these are abelian groups. Yeah, so Q complex count is field. Why? Because Q plus is and Q star comma dot are abelian groups. You can observe here also R complex and R star comma dot are abelian groups. Therefore, it is also field. This is also field. You may take other things. F singleton 0 comma 5, 0 comma 1 comma plus comma dot is a field. Z2 plus 2 modulo 2 is also field. Z3, Z2 nothing but 0 comma 1 only. Z3 plus 3 addition also field. Z5 addition modulo 5 multiplication modulo also field. So Zp comma plus comma plus p and addition multiplication modulo p and multiplication addition modulo p and multiplication modulo p is also field where p is prime. Here my p is prime. So Z comma plus comma dot is not field. Why? Because this non-zero element does not have inverse. So with respect to dot, Z complex is abelian group, but Z comma dot is not, Z star comma dot is not abelian group. Z6 addition modulo 6 and multiplication modulo 6 is not filled. So why? Because some element does not have inverse here in this set also. is you can take that 02468 is also filled. 02468 it is the respect addition model of 10. Multiplication model 10 is a field. Note, a field has at least two elements. They are two different identities. A field has at least two elements. They are two different identity. So up to these topics are we have revisioned. Okay. So in my topic, main topic is external composition. This is very important for defining for find vector space. External composition is or scalar multiplication. You can take that. External composition or scalar multiplication is very crucial, very important for finding vector space. Okay, be careful. Let V is any non-empty set and F is any field. V is any non-empty set and F is field. Then A, U belonging to V. For all A belongs to F, U belonging to V. So this statement is called external composition. This statement is called external composition. So I'm taking that V is any set, F is a field. So I'm taking an element from this one element. I'm taking that I'm taking one element from this. So this element belonging to this set and this element belonging to this set. If I multiply this, I want to do scalar multiplication, right? A, U. If I multiply do these things, so if these two elements belonging to V, if I multiply these two elements to A, U, the resultant element if belonging to V, then this property is called scalar field, right? Let V is any set, non-empty set, F is field, full stop. If AU belongs to V, for all U belongs to, right? You can take that for all. If I take any element in V, it must satisfy these two dots, right? If for all U belongs to and for all A belongs to F, okay? A U belongs to V for all, if for all U belongs to V, for all A belongs to F. So then only we say that external composition property, right? So this, right? So first of all, I'm taking that sets out of sets. So I'm taking that S is equal to, simply I'm taking that S is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. S is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this is my set. Okay, already when discussing sets, so we have already discussed about this. So I'm taking this is my set. Okay, S is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 is my set. So what can I do now here? I want to take any field, right? What are the fields I'm discussed here? Okay, what are the fields I discussed here? Q, right? And R and C. These are the fields. Mainly I discussed, right? So now I want to look at this only, not other things, right? Yeah. Okay, I will take an element to from S, right? What are the elements from S? So you can take that one belonging to S, one belonging to S. You can take any element from here. You may take that, so simply I'm taking that 6, Q is equal to 6, right? 6 belonging to Q. Okay. 6 belonging to Q. If I multiply these things, 1 comma 6, see here, be careful, this is nothing but V. In place of V, I am taking S. 1.6 is equal, operation is 6. I am taking there 1.6 is equal to how much? 6. Does not belong into this 6. Does not have any, right? So 6 does not belong into S. So therefore, S comma Q. Note, S is not satisfies external compression property on Q. Right? If you take N also. Okay, if I take natural number set. Natural number set too. Okay. What are the elements of this set? 1, 2, 3. So natural number set is this. So you can take field is Q is my field simply, right? Q is my field. See, before going to discuss this, so what is the can take any element from here? So I'm taking that phi. Phi belong to N. Yeah. You can take that any element from Q, right? If I take any integers, then what happen? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, anything. So if I multiply this, will happen. I want to take other element which does not belong to N. You can take any element which does not belong to N. Simply can take the 0. So 0 belonging to Q. Right? If I multiply these things. If I multiply these things, 0 into 5, right? So we can take the 0 into 5, that equal to how much? 0. 0 does not belong into, N. So, 0 does not belong to N. So, what can I say that N does not satisfies external compression property on Q. So, this thing happen, right? If I take my field is this, you can take that other element, right? Z. Same Z you also take that. What about Z? If I take Z, if I take Z here, same Z, integer, so Q is my field, you can take one element, suppose 1, if I take root 2 here, root 2 does not belong to it, right, I will take 1 by 2, if I multiply this thing, what happen, 1 by 2, this 1 by 2 does not belong into Z, 1 by 2 does not belong to Z, therefore, Z is also not satisfies external compression property on Q. Rest lambda, right? So if I take Q comma Q, my set is same and this also same. Both are same. So then what happen? You can take any element 1 by 2. You can take element 5. Okay, you can take over 5 by 3. If I multiply both those elements, then what happen? 5 by 6. So, this also belong into, this also belong into Q. So, then what happen? Q, it satisfies external compression property on Q. You can take R. So R comma Q. You can take an element, so 1 root 2 or 1 2 3 4, you can take 1 by 2. So that equal to what happened, if I multiply this thing, that equal to get that 1 by root 2. this 1 by root 2 belongs to R or not? Yes. So this belong into R. Then about R is satisfy external composition property on Q. Similarly, you can take that C. Why? Because this is very crucial, right? C. You can take that I in this set, right? I'm taking 1. So 1 did I equal to how much here? I only. C, I'm in C, I'm taking I. I'm taking 1 in Q. If I multiply both, we'll get Q. So this element also belong into C. So therefore, C is also satisfies external composition property on this set. So this, if you understood this thing, you will easily understand vector space condition. Yeah, so I'm taking 1 in 1 belongs to n, 1 by 2 belongs to f, 1 by 2 into 1 equal does not resemble f. Therefore, n is not, does not satisfy external composition power over Q. If I take V equal W, F equal to Q, 0 belongs to W, 1 by 2 belongs to F, if I multiply 0 belongs to F. Under some conditions, if I multiply some elements, okay, but I'm marking that every element in Q and every element in V. That's why 1 belongs to W, 1 by 2 belongs to F. If I take like this, 1 into 1 by 2 equal to 1 by 2 does not belong to F, W therefore is also not satisfied. W also not satisfied external component now, right? Similarly, here f is any field, right? You may take that w external also not satisfy so external composition property or f, right? Yeah, f is equal to n, but n is not field. I'm not working this thing, so w equal to I'm taking w and n. If I take like this, so not working. You can take the z also, right? You can take z is not to satisfy external composition property, right? Okay, W satisfies external composition property over N. In the above definition, instead of field, we may take some non-empty sets, right? So instead of field, if I take any non-empty set, then what happen? Z satisfies external composition property over N W Z. Okay. See, if I take instead of field, if I take any non-empty set, then what happen? V equal W, F equal to N. If I take that, 3 belongs W, 5 belongs to N. If I multiply 3 into 5 equal 15 belongs to W. If I take any element in this set, all element belongs to this set. If I multiply then what happen? We'll get every element belongs to W. Therefore, W satisfies the external power comparison on N. So similarly, so what happen here? Z satisfies external composition over N, W, Z. Z does not satisfy external composition over Q or C. Q satisfies external composition over N, W, Z, Q. Q does not satisfy external composition over R, C. Singleton 0 satisfies external composition power over N if I take anything. So these are the main reasons, right? We will look at how we are external composition over, right? Because if I take that, simply one reason is for satisfying composition. If my set is this Q, Q satisfies external composition over the subsets of this, right? Q satisfies external composition over the subset of this. What are subset of Q? Z. You may take that Q also, every subset, right? Subset of R equal to Q, both are equal. Subset of Z, superset. And W and N. So that means Q satisfies external composition over either one, right? Similarly, Z is satisfies external composition over Z, W, N. W satisfies external composition, right? Similarly, if I take R, R satisfies external composition R. So as well as if subset R superset R equal to Q, right? So these things, all these things. So that means R is satisfies external composition property over these sets. Similarly, C also. So already you know that C. C is also satisfies external composition over C, R, Q, and Z, W, N. So this thing. If I say that any set which satisfies external composition property, which is which is superset of is subset, right? If I take that Q does not satisfy external composition property over R. Q does not satisfy external composition over R, right? If I take 1 here, if I take 2 root 2, then what happened? We multiply, we will get to root 2, will get, right? Root 2 is does not belong into this set. That's why this set does not satisfy external composition over R. Why? Because R is superset of Q. That's why it is not satisfies. Similarly, Q is not satisfying external composition over C. Similarly, you can take that R is also not satisfies external composition property over C. Why? Because if I take root 1 here, you can take I. 1 and I equal to how much? I does not belong into this set. Therefore, 1 R is also not satisfying external composition power over C. Okay. So, Z satisfies this set already just now explained. We can represent and recall it. Okay, vector space. What is the definition of vector space first of all? Let V be a non-empty set and A be any field. If V satisfies the following properties over the field F, then we say that V is vector space over the field F. Let V be a non-empty set and F be any field. If V satisfies the following properties over the field F, then we say that V is vector space over the field F. V is the vector space over the field F. It is denoted by V over F. So first one, closure property. Closure is what? U plus V belongs to U implies. So, U plus V belongs to V for all U comma belongs to V. Associative property. U plus V plus W is equal to U plus V plus W for all U comma V comma W belongs to V. Identity property. U plus 0 is equal to 0 plus U is equal to U for all U comma belongs to V. So, 0 is the identity element in V with respect to addition. Inverse property. U plus minus U that equal to minus U plus U equal to 0 for all U belongs to U, where minus U is an inverse element of U in V. Abelian property. U plus V is equal to V plus U for all U comma V belongs to F. Sixth one. External composition property. CU belongs to V for all U comma V, U belongs to V and C belongs to F. This is external composition property. Next one. Other property. So, distributive law property. So, CU plus V is equal to CU plus CV for all C belongs to F and E comma belongs to V. C plus D into U that equal to CU plus DU for all C comma D belongs to F and U comma belongs to V. Next property C into DU is equal to CD that equal to U. C into DU is equal to CD into U for all C comma D belongs to F and U belongs to F. Tenth one, 1 dot U is equal to U for all U belongs to V, where 1 is identity element in vector space V. So that means, so a set V is said to be vector space over the field F, it must satisfy these following properties. So that means simply you can say that V complex is a, for showing these all five properties, simply you can say that V complex is an abelian group. Sixth one, external composition and distributive law, and tenth one is 1 dot U is equal to U dot 1 dot U is equal to U for all U belongs to V. Okay, simply you can say that. Which are the vector spaces, which are not vector spaces, right? So, I want to discuss this. So, you can take that, first of all, V is any set and a vector space, right? I am taking that N, no? So, N is my set. What are the fields? So, you know that fields are Q, okay, R, and C. These are the fields. What are theta already? You know that n w z q r c. These are the my sets. I am going to check that which are the vector spaces or not, right? Simply we can observe that external boundary, right? So n is a superset of q, sorry, n is subset of q. So n is subset of q, you can write that vector space symbol is v or f. This is our v, this are equal to v, this are equal to f. So I am writing here other thing. So I am writing here n. Okay, n over f, n over q. Whether this is vector space or not. Okay, n over q. So what can I verify that? I want to verify that external composition property. You can take that 1 here. In this element, you can take that 1 by 2. 1 into 1 by 2 does not belong to 1, n. So it does not satisfy external property. Therefore, it is not a vector space. Similarly, you can take the w also. So if I take that w, so w or q, one belongs to w and q, 1 by 2 belongs to q. 1 into 1 by 2 equal to 1 by 2. 1 by 2 does not belong into w. So it is not satisfy external composition property. So therefore, it is also not a vector space. You can take that z. Same, I take that z. So 1 belongs to z and q belongs to 1 by 2. 1 by 2 belongs to q. 1 by 2 does not belong to z. 1 by 2 does not belong into z. So therefore, it is also not a vector space. If I take q over q, if I take that q over q, you can take any element. So 1 by 2, then what happened? 1 into 1 by 2, 1 by 2, 1 by 2 q. If I take any number 3 by 4 5 by 4 6 by 4, then what happened? Every number multiply will get q only. Therefore it is a vector space. So next you can take that r over q. R over q is, so if I take R over Q, so R over Q, what happen here? If I take any number, so 1, if I take that root 2, this set, 1 in this set, 1 into root 2 equal to root 2, this belongs to, if I take 1 by 2, that equal to 1 by root 2, also belongs to, if I take any number, if I multiply, we'll get this, right, because Q subset of R. So therefore, so if I take any number, it satisfies external composition. Therefore, this is also vector space. So therefore, this is vector space. If I take C over Q, same, I can take any number root 2, 1, I 1 plus 1 plus I plus 1. You can take that 1 by some phi. If I multiply here, what again? 1 by phi I plus 1 by phi. That belongs to C. Therefore, this is also vector space. So here n over q, w over q, z over, not vector space, q over q, r over q and q over q are vector space. What you have observed here, if I take this set is form vector space over this, so our condition is, simply you can observe that w is superset or equal to f, then simply logic is v over f is vector space. Simple logic. Or the other way you can write that f is subset r equal to v, f is subset r equal to v, So then V over F is vector space. If V is subset r equal to subset of not equal to, I'm writing here, V subset of F, if V subset of S, then V over F is not vector space. F subset r equal to V, then V over F is vector space. V subset r equal to F, then V over F is not vector space. So we can observe that here easily. F subset r equal to V, V over F is vector space. V subset r equal to F, V over F is not vector space. This thing you have to observe here. You can observe here why it is not vector space. So W, Q is not set of W, therefore it is not vector space. Q is not set of W, is not vector space. Q is not set of W, is not vector space. Q is not set of Z, is not vector space. Q is subset r equal to this vector space. Q subset of R, therefore it is vector space. Q subset of C is vector space, right? These things happen, right? So similarly, you can easily write here. If I take any subset of what are the fields? So here we have fields are R, C, and Q. These are the fields. So now vector space forms using these sets only, not other sets, any other sets, right? So what are the possibilities? Q subset of R, right? R is subset of C. So that's why R over Q. Why? Because Q subset of R and R over R are the vector spaces. And C over Q C over Q and C over R and C over C are the vector space. Already I discussed that Q over Q already. Just now we discussed about this Q over Q. So these are the vector space only we have found from using these sets. For other sets we are unable to find. If I take that Q over R. It is not vector space. Why? Because already we know that V over F is a vector space if F subset of R equal to V. F subset R equal to V, then it is vector space. In this case, what happened? R is not subset of Q. Therefore, it is not vector space. Similarly, R over Q over C also not vector space. It is also not vector space. I can say that C over R also, sorry, R over C is also not vector space. Why? Because this bigger number. So it is not unable to satisfy external composition property. So these are not vector spaces. So I'm reasoning here now. Q over Q vector spaces, R over Q vector spaces, and C over Q, R over O, R, C over R, these are the vector space. Q over F, F is equal to 0, 1 is also vector space. R over F, C over F, Z over F, over F, Z over F. If I take this, so it satisfies vector space properties. If I take like this, so non vector spaces are Q over R, R over Q, R over C, N over Q, N over F, N over C, N over F. W over Q, W over R, W over C are not vector spaces because this set does not satisfy vector space. You can simply observe that the inside set must be subset of W outside set, right? So then the field is subset of this set, then only it is vector space. See, simply observe that Q subset R equal to Q vector space, Q subset of R it's a vector space, Q subset of C, so R subset of R, R subset of C, C subset of R, that's why it's a vector spaces. R is a subset of Q, not vector spaces. C is a subset of not equal to subset of Q. That is not vector spaces, right? these are the vector spaces and these are the not vector spaces, right? So this about the vector spaces, tomorrow we'll discuss the other thing. So thank you for watching this. Tomorrow we'll discuss about the vector spaces definitions, so problems.